Hello, I'm Jody Gale, County Extension Agent with Utah State University Extension Service. Welcome to our website. Today we thought we'd demonstrate how to take a soil sample. Soil sampling is one of those critical chores that you need to do once in a while around your yard to collect a soil sample, send that in for analysis. And it's a way to get a lot of really good information about the type of soil, your nutrient levels in preparation for fertilizing for the growing season. Probably the most common tool we have for collecting soil samples is this soil probe. Soil probe is basically has a T-handle on it, fairly rugged metal. It has a tube on the end. There's a little mark right here that shows that about a foot distance from the end, has a cutting tip on it, and the side is cut away right here so that as you push it in the ground, it cuts a plug or a core. That core will fill up this part of the soil sampler, and it's very easy to do it. When you collect a soil sample, you want to have a very uniform piece of the soil. That's why we collect it in the form of a plug. If you use a shovel and you get all top and no bottom, then the soil sample will be biased and the results that you get back from the soil lab will not be accurate. This probe makes it possible to take the same diameter of soil, that 12 inches deep on the when you pull the soil sample itself. We'll demonstrate this just in just a moment in a garden situation on how to collect the sample itself. The materials we have this kit that's essentially available that you can come by our extension office. It's a good idea to call before you come in. We have a lot of call for this, but we'd love to have you call us at 435-893-0470 and check and see if the sampler is available. And you're welcome to check it out and use it for that sampling purpose. Once you've collected a sample using this bucket where you've collected multiple cores, you put the cores in the bucket, mix them up thoroughly, and take out just enough that will fill this small box. We have a bag that comes with part of the kit. The soil goes in the bag. Once you have that put together, then just put the bag and the soil in the box, fold it together. We have a form that you can use to identify the type of soil situation you have, whether you're in an orchard or a garden. Ask several questions that helps the lab technician make appropriate recommendations. Put this inside the box and then go ahead and mail it in. It's all pre-addressed to Utah State University Soil Lab. This whole process, once you pull the sample and send it off, takes approximately 10 days. If you'll include your email address on the sample form, the USU Analytical Laboratory will send the results back to you via email. Thank you, and we'll demonstrate the sampling process in our next segment. Now for demonstration on how to pull the individual cores, that's part of collecting the subsamples that will become the full sample that you will submit to the USU Soils Laboratory. Here we have our soil sampler. These work very effectively in collecting a uniform diameter plug that represents the same quantity of dirt at the bottom of the plug as you do the top. This works much better than using a shovel. Shovels, you usually oversample the top of the soil profile, undersample the bottom, and the soil sample is almost always biased. So pulling with a sampler is quite easy by just simply grabbing hold of the handle, pushing this down into the soil to the mark that's on the sampler that's about 12 inches deep, turning the sampler, pulling it out, and it takes a core that's approximately 12 inches long that represents the top and the bottom of the sample, or the soil profile. Using a screwdriver and a small bucket, the individual core is knocked out into the bucket, and that represents a sub-sample. We'll now demonstrate how to sample an entire garden area where you need to collect multiple cores or multiple plugs that will eventually make up the entire sample. collecting multiple cores, putting all of the subsamples or the subcores into a bucket. The next part of the process is quite simple. Just simply mixing up the soil material very thoroughly, taking the little clods and rubbing those between your fingers, breaking those up so that there's no bias that's built into the subsample, mixing it thoroughly. The soils lab does not need to have very much soils to do the analysis with. Once the sample has been mixed well, rocks and organic matter and anything that's present in the subsample should be included. Don't exclude those from the material. Fill a small portion in the plastic bag that's provided with the soil sampling kit. Because we've mixed all of the cores together, what we get in the bag is quite representative of the entire surface of the garden because of the zigzaggy fashion where the sample was collected. The bag then should be twisted together, folded over, putting a bread sack type twist tie on, or a piece of tape will help secure it. Using the box that's provided with the address to the Utah State University Analytical Lab,